In this video, we'll show you how to display data that you have in a Xano backend on a WeWeb page. There will be three steps. First, we'll need to add the Xano data source plugin to our WeWeb project. Then, we'll need to get data from Xano into a WeWeb collection. Finally, we'll display that data on a page in WeWeb. Let's start with step one, which is adding the Xano data source plugin. In WeWeb, I want to go ahead and click on the plugins icon. In here, I have options to add plugins. I want to go to my data source plugins and select the Xano data source plugin and add it here. I'm invited to add my Xano API key. We have a link to the Xano use documentation, which reminds you where to find your API key. So it is in account. We can generate one. So let's do that here in account. Let's go ahead and generate an API key. Remember to keep this key extremely private. In my case, after recording this video, I will revoke it because I'm currently sharing it in public with you. But you know, remember to revoke your API keys if you ever do build in public stuff. Once you've added your API key, you can select your Xano instance. In this case, I'm borrowing Florian's, and click on continue. Here you have an advanced setting, which we will not cover specifically in this course. Data source is a Xano functionality that allows you to test your app on a testing environment instead of affecting your live data in production. This testing concept is very important in web development and one that you will want to dig further into as you make progress and scale your app. For now, let's click on continue. Now we're ready to add a collection. Let's click on the big blue button. Okay, so here I'm invited to select a source and name my collection. So let's call it calls from Xano. And we can create a folder if we wanted to. This can be helpful once you start having a lot of data collections. For now, we'll leave it at that. And the source will be our Xano data source plugin here. We'll stay in dynamic mode for the purposes of building a dynamic web app MVP. We don't need static or cached. These are more advanced settings that you might want to use in specific use cases, which we'll cover in separate courses. So we'll go ahead and click continue. And so once we've selected our source, we'll be able to access all the API groups that we have in our Xano instance. So let's have a look at our Xano before moving on. In Xano, I have four tables: calls, contact, content, and users. In our calls, it's the table we're going to work with. It's basically a list of phone calls made by specific users. So this is a related field to our user table. And with a list of the duration, the number of minutes that each call lasts, and if it's a domestic call or an international call. And in Xano, we also have a bunch of different endpoints, API endpoints. And in this case, we're using these endpoints for level one. So these are the endpoints that are related to our calls table. And this is the endpoint that that we're going to use. If we were using the REST API plugin, we could copy the endpoint and paste it in our REST API collection. But in this case, we're using the native integration with Xano. So what we'll do is we'll select this one here, this API group that is interesting for us, and select the endpoint. So in our case, we want to get all the calls from our table. So we'll click on continue. And you see now that the data is fetched from Xano, and it appears here in WeWeb. Now, you see here we have 1,000 items. And what's interesting is that if you disable the formatted option here, you will see that this is basically a list of objects. And you see it starts on index 0 here. And if we go right to the bottom, it ends on 999. So from 0 to 999, that's the 1,000 objects that WeWeb was telling us we had. Now, why am I showing you this? I'm showing you this because if you're a complete beginner, it might be a little bit intimidating, but it's important to understand that this, all these numbers from the index says 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way to 999, these are indexes in an array, what's called an array or a list, depending on the programming language that you're using. We'll call it a both, just to get you familiar with both terms. And basically, each item in the list, you can think, is a row in your table. So in your Xano table or your Airtable base or your Google Sheets, it can help if you think of a spreadsheet sometimes. But the idea is each object here is a row in your base, in your Xano table. And then what we see here inside the object, so the each object is a row, you see ID, call to, date, duration, user ID, type. These are called keys in programming languages, and it corresponds to the column names that you have in your table. And then, so these are the keys, and then for each key and each row, there is a value. So this is a value for call to, this is the value for the key date, this is the value for the key duration. It may seem unimportant at this time, but it's you will find that it's helpful to understand this, understand how objects are structured in programming. For now, don't worry too much about it. Just know that this is a list of object, an array of object. That is what the Xano API returns to WeWeb. And this will be helpful when we want to display the data on the page in WeWeb. Now, something else that's important to note is that we fetch the data, and afterwards we are able to sort the data or filter, paginate it or filter it. So for example, we could say, I want to add a condition where the duration is less than 100 minutes. So let's save and test. And now we only see 19 objects in WeWeb. So from index 0 to index 18. This may create the impression that you're only loading these 19 items in your user's browser. That is not the case. The 1,000 items are still in your user's browser. This is how the internet works. If you add what we call a front-end filter, so this is a front-end filter. This is a filter that we make on the WeWeb side of things, and it would be the same using other tools. This is a filter that you add after the front-end, after the user's browser has already fetched the data from Xano. So if you want to load less data in your front-end, then this is the call that you need to change in Xano. So you would need in Xano, in your API calls, you would need to add a filter, for example, saying only return the calls where the duration is less than 100. The reason I'm telling you this is because browsers have limited capacity. So if you load too much data into a user's browser, it will crash, or at the very least, it will slow down significantly. And this is not related to WeWeb. This is how the internet works. So if you load too much data, pages will be slow. We've all experienced it going on a web page, and it's very slow. It lags. It means that the backend, the server, is sending a lot of data to the user's browser, and that browser needs to. Our browser needs to download that data, and it slows it down. Now, how much data is too much data? It's difficult to say. One way I like to think about it is that you want users with a small mobile data plan to be able to access your web app and to enjoy the experience. Also, you don't want to load any data that is confidential because it may be seen in the front end. Okay, now that we have our 19 items, let's display them on a page. Let's go here. What we have here is we have a table element, and here we can bind to a collection list. We see this little purple icon here, and this will invite us to tell the table element which items we want to display. So the items we want to display are in our collection here in the data tab. We want to get all the calls from Xano. We want to get our collection calls from Xano. And we see here suddenly on the page, suddenly we actually have 19 items on the page instead of just three. And if we click here on our text element, which is here in the navigator, we now have the context. We can bind to information from our collection. So here, for example, the phone number. And we see here all the phone numbers from our Xano collection. And we can bind the minutes. What we can do here is we can go ahead and say the duration is 10. And if we wanted to, we could actually use a no-code formula, a simple no-code formula to maybe concatenate this information. So the concatenate formula allows you to put text next to each other. So here we have our minute, and what we could do is we could say after minute we want to add a little space min, because in Xano we only have this information here. We have the number, so here we have this duration, the number, and here what we're saying is we're adding minutes. And that's how you display data in WeWeb. Now, remember what I was telling you about filtering data in the front end and the back end? Well, if we open up our browser here and refresh the page, because we've added these calls from Xano on our page, our browser will go and get these calls. We can see it here. These are the calls that we made from Xano. And here you see that even though we only have 19 items on the page, we actually still see the 1,000 items. The browser still downloaded those 1,000 items. So this significantly slows down the browser compared to, you know, loading 1,000 items is slower than loading 19 items. And also, if by any chance you had some confidential information, so for example, if you only wanted to load the calls from the user who is currently logged in, then you would inadvertently be sharing calls from other users if you had your filter in the front end instead of at your back end, instead of adding a filter on the Xano API call. That's it. That's how you get data from Xano into WeWeb and display it on the page. I hope you've learned a lot. Don't worry if lists and arrays and objects and front-end filters and back-end filters are a little bit confusing for now. You'll learn little by little, no problem. We've got your back, and we will cover these topics again throughout this course and other courses so that little by little your knowledge is strengthened. If anything was unclear, please do not hesitate to tell us, to give us that feedback so we can clarify and improve these videos for you.